In this last episode of Stormwater at Home, we're switching gears a little to talk about what you can do to ensure that the water coming off your property is free of debris, chemicals, and other pollutants that threaten the quality of our rivers and lakes.
The first rule of pollution prevention is to remember that everything washed into storm drains flows directly to nearby waterways. Trash, lawn chemicals, leaves and grass clippings, dog waste, car oil, and anything else on the ground can find its way into streams during even the smallest of rainstorms. Fortunately, taking a few simple steps around your home or business can go a long way towards safeguarding water quality and aquatic habitats. Pick up any trash that blows into your yard as soon as you can and clean up after your pets. Use fertilizer only when a soil test says it's necessary, and sweep your driveway and sidewalk immediately after application to collect particles scattered by the spreader. Check the weather report before applying lawn chemicals as well to ensure they're not immediately washed down the drain. In the fall, rake and bag leaves or use a mulching mower. In winter, use salt sparingly or not at all. Letting your lawn grow a little longer in the summer will also help minimize weed growth so you or your lawn service don't need to apply pesticides. And consider using integrated pest management strategies. Keep your car well maintained to prevent oil and other chemical leaks. Even if they're in your shed or garage, store paints, oils, and other chemicals securely to prevent spills.
If you happen to have a conventional asphalt driveway like this one, and it's time to reseal it, consider using an asphalt-based seal coat instead of coal tar seal coat, which contains much higher levels of compounds linked to cancer in humans. Preventing stormwater pollution starts with all of us, at home, at work, at school, and at play. Make it a habit to think twice about where your waste ends up. Together we can do this. We can protect and improve our waterways and the wildlife and communities that rely on them.